I know very few senators, cops, or politicians who hate the sight of dollars. The organization has plenty of dollars. There's plenty of Lugers and Colts. If it's a matter of choosing between a banknote or a bullet, most people make the same decision. That's human nature, I guess. Of course, there are some exceptions. Me, for example. I know when not to talk, but nobody believes me. Neither the cops nor the others. They use top-class killers, guys who know their business. When one of the big boys gets caught, then it's the real panic. Yeah, then they really get scared.
To the chambers of the Senate Subcommittee Investigations on Organized Crime.
Mr. Redosa, for the last time, and before this session closes, we are asking you once more, will you please cooperate with this committee?
I respectfully decline to answer on the grounds that the question may tend to incriminate me.
The witness is within his constitutional rights. He cannot be forced to answer a question.
Well, what do you think of it?
It's a risky proposition. But all things considered, worth the gamble, provided we can get Riedosa released before Tuesday. There's been too much publicity about this project, and I don't like it. Before I put my name on paper recommending a loan for $400 million, Riedosa must be cleared. The board of directors of the bank won't go for it. Not with your chairman indicted by a grand jury.
Look, we got enough legal talent to staff the whole United Nations. Now, I'm telling you, Rubiosa will be released.
That's exactly what you mean, I thought. Look, today's Thursday. Tomorrow, even lawyers go on weekend. And the board meets Tuesday at 11 a.m. They won't release Rubiosa till they've played their last card, Rudy Lipschitz. We can't take any chances now. The governor's determined to blow us sky high. And personally, I don't believe Riedosa will be released. Let's face fact, they must know where Rudy is. Or if they don't, they'll find him and subpoena him. Rudy will talk. And the commission will have all the vital information at its fingertips about the syndicate. And enough evidence to send Riedosa away for life.
Rudy will never talk. They don't even know where he is. He had been in France for 17 years, and he changed his name to Rudy Hamburg. Look, I know what you're driving at, but let's give the legal experts just a little bit of time before we make hasty decisions.
Your friends already tried to get rid of Rudy Hamburg. for $400 million, I have the right to make the decision. And I'm telling you, this time, get rid of him.
What do you know? How's it going, Phil?
Have we been introduced?
You come calling?
Yeah, I got a cute little secretary upstairs. I think I got a chance with her. You coming up in the elevator too, Lieutenant?
No.
Well, I didn't think you were going to send for the Marine.
I'll meet you at Grand Central at 6:30, next to the barber shop. He'll tell me everything tonight. Okay.
Mr. Hyman, please.
Who's calling?
Mr. Colarzo.
Come this way.
Hi, Phil.
I want to see the boss.
That's nice. You want to see President Johnson, too?
No, I just want to see Mr. Hyman.
Mr. Hyman's in a meeting. He told me to give you this envelope.
Thanks. Will you tell him I'm here?
What do you want to see him about? Because I'm here to say if it's important or not.
You're here to open and shut doors. Say yes, sir, no, sir. Are you going to tell him I'm here or not?
I said he's in a meeting.
You tell him I'm here. Now.
Mr. Colarzo insists on seeing you.
Show him in.
That sort of thing.
I don't like it either, sir.
Carl's one of my men, and he does a good job.
He does a bad job. He didn't even search me.
Phil, where do you think you are? We gave up searching visitors a long time ago. Of course, if you insist, I'll ask him back in again.
If you want.
Meet the tough guy.
Hello, Ben. Shaft.
Hello.
You know, I think the interview is over. Carl? Show him up.
Listen, Phil. I'm an open-minded guy. I allow a lot of things around here. But this, I can't put up with.
Okay.
Now, I'm glad you see it my way. Now, why don't you take your money and...
I want to talk about Rudy Hamburg.
What's there to talk about? You gave us his address, you got your money. What else do you want?
I want his contract.
About Ben and Shaft, have that. What, are you hungry for money?
Matt, other things.
What other things?
Personal.
Well, if they're personal, so much the more reason to talk about it. Out with it.
I've got a sister. Rudy got her pregnant, and he dropped her. Oh, he was just having fun. She was 16 years old. She didn't tell me or my mother about it. She had it taken care of by one of those butchers. Did something to her. She went crazy. We had to put her in one of those homes. That was 17 years ago. And once a month for 17 years, I've gone and visited her.
Phil, we don't give out contracts in cases like these. A killer with a reason makes things twice as easy for the police.
You three are the only ones that know about it. You give me the contract. We'll all come out ahead, I promise you that.
Just supposing I accept. We'd have to work out which of these two gentlemen you'd be replacing.
Forget it. What about you, Ben?
That depends upon the price.
Name it.
20%. Cash in advance in case Rudy comes out on top.
I'll give you 10%. Take it or leave it.
You'd think I'd take it.
Yes, I'd do.
Don't forget, Phil Boyd. If I go, I get 50,000 bucks.
I don't think you'll make it, Ben. That monkey on your back slows you down. Okay?
Okay.
How about it, Mr. Hunt?
Well, we'll think about it. I'll let you know.
Yes, sir.
Hold it, Phil. If we're gonna be partners, let's lay it out. If Rudy Hamburg talks, it could be disastrous for the organization. Which means that if tomorrow Rudy Hamburg isn't liquidated, even if it's only your fault, we're both in serious trouble.
TWA, your tickets for Paris, sir. Thank you.
What time's the next plane from us?
Not till tomorrow,
sir.
You
sure?
Yes.
What time?
7:30 a.m.
Excuse me, can I dial Marseille direct?
Yes, sir, you can.
Thank you.
Make a move. I'll wait for detailed instructions. Between 10 and 11, okay. You get information on planes arriving from Paris tonight or tomorrow morning? Yes, I know, but then they may have changed the schedule.
Waiting for someone?
No, I'm waiting for a letter.
Oh, it's late, and there's so much I have to do.
Did you pick up the money at the bank?
Yes, 30,000 francs.
What do you want to go into business for? You know you don't have a head for that kind of thing. Besides, I have enough for two.
For two, perhaps, but not for three.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, look, Rudy, you know there's always been someone standing between us. So I feel that I should take measures.
pass the shrimp, please. Do you speak French?
Not a word.
Ah. Do you, Bruce?
Yes, please.
Have you had a look at Paris? Think of it.
Looks like Hong Kong.
In the warehouse, the gate is always open, even on Sundays, because the mail coming in from Morocco is stored there and picked up on Sunday. If the sliding doors are shut, just slide them open. Do you smoke?
No.
Oh, another thing. As you come in on your left, there is an iron staircase which leads to the office. Oh, here's the key, in case you need it.
But there will be people on the dock.
Yes, most probably. Stragglers who go fishing there, dockers. I advise you not to leave your car on the highway. Might be noticed. You drive it straight on, to the waterfront. Do you have a light?
I have a light, but you have a good memory.
For certain things, excellent.
Does the door to the office open from the inside or from the outside?
From the inside.
Has he changed any of his habits lately?
Yes. He sometimes slips in his office on Saturday night if a boat is expected to dock.
Is there one expected tomorrow?
This could mean he might be in his house in Camargue, duck hunting.
What about his girl?
Don't worry about her. She certainly won't be there.
Good. Waiter?
Check, please.
I'll be waiting for you in room 11. Anything I can do for you?
I'll take a rain check.
Do you know that you've been followed ever since we landed at the airport? The guys across the street.
Well, what is it? I'm keeping his eye on us?
Not I.
Well, who then? The cops? Rudy Hamburg? Look, if he's still down there, why don't we go down and ask him who he is?
What do you want to do, kidnap him? Now listen, you take the 10:30 train for Marseille. At 1:26 a.m., you get off at Dijon. D-I-J-O-N.
D-I-J-O-N.
I'll be waiting in front of the station in the car.
But wouldn't it be easier if I went with you?
No. Now, you wanted this job so badly, and now that you've got it, you do as you're told.
Ain't I entitled to an opinion?
No. Do you mind?
Not at all.
You have the guy at the hotel call you a cab for the Galleon. You can buy your ticket at the station. I'll see you at Dijon.
D-I-J-O-N, 1:26 a.m.
State penitentiaries, but you could have phoned my lawyer to tell him you sent two parcels to Marseille.
What happened? How come?
The lawyer's got hold of a habeas corpus. That operation's got to be stopped.
You're out, and that's the most important thing.
You bet it is, and I want to stay out. That operation has got to be stopped, or I get linked to it and find myself inside again with a murder rap. By the way, was their plane on time?
No, it was a couple of hours late. There was no train from Marseille until 10:30 tonight. That's French time, so I've got a chance to get there first if I catch the 4 p.m. flight.
Well, don't miss that plane.
Ticket for Dijon.
Thank you.
I'll wait for you in the restaurant. How long will you be?
10 minutes.
Right behind you, to the left of the glass doors and down the stairs.
I'd like to put a call through to Marseille, 409-362. Is there a long wait for
just
Marseille?
Just a few minutes.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I thought you were going to wait for me in the restaurant.
No, the restaurant's closed at 10 o'clock and I was afraid you'd get lost.
You're very kind. Too bad we won't spend some time in Paris, shall we?
All right.
The gentleman who wanted to speak to Marseille.
Sorry, the person who asked for the call has left.
Weren't you expecting me?
No.
That's precisely why I came. Well, what's wrong? You all right?
Sure I am. It's not too serious. Nothing really.
Is it business?
Yeah.
But you are happy I'm here, aren't you?
Yeah. But I'd even be happier if you fixed me a cup of coffee.
Remember, the rooms at the Hotel Sainte-Marie are in the name of Burns and Leroux. The map is in the glove compartment. And I've marked it to Marseille and the Rudy's house in Camargue. Should he be there? Good luck, and drive carefully.
Thank you.
Hello? Hello? Yeah, all right. Monday morning, I'll take care of it.
Was that the telephone call you were waiting for?
No, it was Bertrand reporting the arrival of Yamakashi.
Will you please tell me what's worrying you?
Nothing. Nothing that concerns you, anyway.
It concerns me if you're worried.
No, Sylvia.
The old bag running after you again?
Please don't say old bag. It reminds me of my age. No, it's not because of her.
Yes, it is. It's Catherine. You're lying.
Listen, baby.
I want to stay here tonight.
Catherine is really of no significance, whatever. Will you behave like a good girl?
I don't want to behave. And please don't be evasive.
I love you. You call that being evasive? I've got to be alone for 24 hours. Please don't ask me any questions. It'll be rough.
I'm sure that it's she.
No. No, it isn't.
Will you please tell me the truth, Rudy?
You're mistaken.
You promised me you wouldn't see her again. You gave me your word that it was finished, that you wouldn't start up again.
You're wrong, Sylvia.
Prove it to me, then, that I'm wrong.
You must believe me.
Why must I?
Because
you love me? All right. I'm leaving.
Dino, 5 minutes stop. Dino, 5 minutes stop.
They gotta be kidding with those French cigarettes. Where's my bag?
In the back seat.
Oh. Yeah. Well, I know it's not your problem. You don't smoke. But I recommend if anybody wants to give it up, try the French ones.
Where'd it go?
At the station.
No problems.
That's good. Who do you think it was? The House of the Rising Sun. Funny what they've done to it, huh?
Yeah. When I was a kid, there was a colored man that used to play that on his alto sax.
Where you from?
New York City.
Whereabouts?
103rd Street.
Yeah, I used to live near there when I was a kid. Well, way before your time, of course. What kind of games you play as a kid?
What kind of games did I play? The same kind you play. Ringoledio, stoop ball. And on Sundays, we used to go to Central Park and throw rocks at the cops.
Oh, thanks for lending me the book. I read about 300 pages. Yeah, I'm up to that place when Hitler threw out Stefan Zweig and Thomas Mann and Einstein. Sometimes I wonder if our side of the world didn't pick up some bad habits from him.
I don't want to discuss it. When you discuss on this job, you're in a lot of trouble.
I'll be right back. Hey, that broad over there looks like an American. Look. Wait a minute. That ain't ham and eggs. We got the specialty of the house. Listen to those guys. They're talking about horses.
Since when do you understand French?
That language is universal.
We haven't got any time. Get some bread, make a sandwich, let's go.
Thank you. like California.
Mr. Burns here.
Mr. Burns. This way.
Looks like the Bronx.
Yeah.
Good morning, sir.
Our reservation's for two, Mr. LaRue and Mr. Burns.
Yes. Oh, Louise. Good morning, sir.
Morning.
Thank you.
Hey. And listen, don't call me until about 1 o'clock.
All right, sir.
Room service, please. Will you have someone send us some towels? Thank you.
Pretty crummy joint, isn't
it? Yeah, where do you usually go when you go on a job? At the Ritz?
Sure. Whenever I'm in Washington, I can always be the White House.
Why don't you go inside and use the hot water? Yes?
Your towels, sir.
Oh, good. Thank you.
Will these do?
Fine.
Thank you.
Don't you think we should have gone over to Rudy's office right away?
It's all the plan. Now just relax. We'll get some sleep first.
Can you change $5?
Where'd you get that from?
This morning there was a fellow who asked about two men. And when he left, he gave me the $5. Must be an American.
He left a message?
No. Tell me, how much is it worth?
About 25 francs. I'll change it for you.
What do you want for breakfast?
What?
Breakfast.
Oh, give me a couple of scrambled eggs and coffee, will you?
Hello? Room service, please. I would like to order breakfast for two. Scrambled eggs, coffee, orange juice. Thank you.
Well, what are the plans?
We're going to drive out to the warehouse. I hope it's empty.
Well, shouldn't we look the place over first?
I got all the details.
Look, Shaft, I don't mean to be nosy, but would you mind letting me in on some of your secrets?
Your gun is in the suitcase on the left-hand side. It's not a gun, it's a cannon.
I like the weight. It's my security blanket. What's the time, Ted?
We've got to finish the job by 7 o'clock. And we drive to Barcelona, leave the car, and grab the first plane from New York.
Come in.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'm sorry about the toilet.
Oh, that's all right.
Miss?
Yes?
What is Marseille like?
Very quiet now. About 1 million people and 120,000 pieds-noirs. You know, Algerian refugees. But they don't stay very long. There's little work, and the harbor is very quiet.
Do the Corsicans still run the town?
There's nothing much to run anymore. The real action is in Nice. The good old days are over in Marseille. Oh, by the way, there was a man asking for you this morning.
Did he leave a message?
No, but he must have been an American. Because he gave the night porter a $5 tip. Do you need anything else?
No, thank you, honey.
Thank you.
What do you think it was?
I don't know. I'm going to call Daisy. Now she's the only one that knows where we are. Hello? Operator, give me Paris. MAI 8030. Answering service.
Call New York.
Okay. Hello? Operator? Give me long distance, United States. I want to put in a call to New York, person to person.
To Mr. Herman, for Mr. Burns. The number there is Hudson, 61717.
Now listen, if you can't reach him at that number.
Drive in Westfield, Connecticut. The number is Westfield 71522. Thank you.
Can I use your tub?
Sure, go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
good old days are not only over in Marseille, they're over in the States, too. The only way you can pick up a buck today is honestly, legally, and have a clean pass.
Hello.
Who is it?
I had to spell out for the operator.
You know what a guy like Rudy Hamburg could do to the organization if he decided to testify before the commission? You know what's involved with Rudosa and the organization? They run banks, real estate outfits that control towns, whole towns. It's all legal. That's why we're here, to keep Rudosa's past clean and legal. That's why Rudy has to be hit.
He's a witness. Poor guy would have been better off if he was in on the killing. Then his testimony would have needed corroboration, see? Without it, he'd be homeless. You ever heard of corroboration?
What about it?
You can commit 10,000 crimes and never be bothered. Provided that no living witness can declare that he saw you come in any of them.
It's not bad, huh?
You bring your mother along to the state of New York. You get a gun. Now, you gotta look around, make sure nobody's watching. Bang! Now, you go 10 yards on and a cop picks you up. You can go home whistling. Again, provided there are no living witnesses. Even if you got an accomplice, there's no risk. Say after a crime, your accomplice squeals on you, giving details of how you committed the murder. You can keep on whistling. Even before the grand jury. See, his testimony has no value without corroboration, see? So, they can't indict you. They can't even keep you in jail for 24 hours. You come out as white as snow. And the cop on duty, the one who hollered at you, you know, when they brought you in, now he begs your pardon, he licks your boots, he drives you home. On the other hand, look out for the witness who's not an accomplice. You know, the guy who saw you commit the crime from his window. Now, there you won't get away with it. Unless, of course, the witness meets with a little accident. A falling brick, truck goes through a red light. Anything that'll keep him from testifying before the grand jury. But sometimes a brick misses its mark, truck breaks down, and some witnesses are good at avoiding accidents. But a couple of shots, fired from a gun held in the hands of trained killers like you and me, that's why we're here, to make sure.
Professor, are you finished?
School's out.
Hello. Hyman can't be reached until tomorrow. Let's go.
It's 1 o'clock in Paris. I hope it's all over and that Rudy was warned in time.
I hope you're right. Rudy Hamburg.
No, he's gone shooting. Well, you know, duck hunting. At his country place. Hunting in the Camargue. Oh, good morning, Mr. Lemoine. Mr. Hamburg's gone to the country. The ship's coming in now. I can see it. Yes, thank you, Mr. Lemoine. Bye.
looking at?
Just wondering. About me?
Yeah.
What about me?
I don't think you'd really like to know. Unless you tell me to mind my own business. What do you do with all the dough you make? I'm sorry, I shouldn't ask that question.
You're you and I'm me. Asking never hurt anybody.
That's right. From time to time, it doesn't hurt to talk, huh? You got somebody?
What do you mean, somebody?
Somebody. A girl you live with. Don't you like them?
Yeah. But it depends what for.
You know what for. Look, 9 out of 10 guys in our racket have private lives. They got wives, they got kids.
That's their business. I'd have to be in an entirely different business if I wanted to get a girl mixed up in my life.
You don't like me, do you?
No, I don't.
Why not?
Don't you know?
Well, I think I can guess. I'd like to hear you spell it out.
We're on a contract, so let's keep our distance.
I'm the friendly type.
I don't want your friendship.
Why not?
With friends like you, I don't need any enemies. Rudy Hamburg was a friend of yours. A real good friend. And you asked to kill him for $50,000.
You're dead wrong.
What's it for, then? The honor of your sister?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Back in New York, you couldn't sell me that line. Why don't you admit it? I'm in it for the money. I'm a rat.
I couldn't kill a friend for money. Well, you're a nice guy.
No, I'm not a nice guy. Clean.
You sure you're on the right track?
You're damn right I'm on the right track.
Ooh.
What time is it?
4:30. Want some orange juice?
Yeah, but put a little scotch in it.
All right, I understand. I'll be back in an hour.
Sylvia, where are you going?
I'm going to the farm.
Take the car and...
Hello? What's the matter with you? Are you crazy or what?
I told you never to come here. You came in spite of that. Now get out.
No.
For the last time, I'm telling you to take the car and get out.
I don't see why I can't stay.
I'll explain it to you tomorrow.
Tomorrow is too late. And if I leave now, I'll never come back. Is that what you want?
No. It's not what I want.
You don't love me anymore.
Yes, I do.
You love me. But between you and me, it's all over.
Will you go now?
You act as though you were afraid. Is it me you're afraid of?
No, I'm not afraid.
You know, if you would explain, I might even be able to help.
Go away.
Like the Florida Keys, don't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Wow. Hey, pull in there, will you? Just for a minute. Hey, how about this, huh?
Yeah, it's kind of pretty.
Wow.
You know, we haven't got much time.
What time is it?
4:30.
We still have a minute. Look at that. Don't you have any friends?
I can't afford friends. I work within certain rules. One of the rules is I can't have friends on the job.
What about when you're off the job?
Well, that's none of your business.
Hey, you know I heard about you in New York? I heard that you had guts and you were a real great guy. I wanted to meet you. Because there aren't too many real great guys around. Okay, now you know. There are certain things that are clean. And other things which aren't. Do you think our work is clean?
I'm not ashamed of it. Only gutless wonders are ashamed of what they do.
Yeah, but do you think it's clean?
Yes, I do.
So do I. We got a great organization. We got our own laws. And all the guys know those laws. And if you make one little mistake, you get a bullet right in the head. That's it. That's where the business is. But it's among us. We kill among the organization. We don't kill other people. If one day I get a bullet in the head, well, if I don't go to the chair first. Well, it's normal. You know that? It's correct. If I kill, it's right. If I get killed, that's right. There are certain things that are right. And then there are other things that are just plain rotten.
For instance,
to kill a friend, to go out and to kill a friend.
What would you do?
I let the organization wipe me out just to protect a friend. I would. Mm-hmm. And if my friend were a marked guy, I'd let somebody else do it. I couldn't do it. I would rather get myself killed first.
Well, you know what he did to my sister, huh?
Oh, come on. You're repeating yourself. Rudy wasn't that kind of a guy and wasn't his style.
That's what you heard. But that's the difference, see? That's the difference between what you hear and what is fact. Why the hell do you think I want a contract to kill Rudy? That guy was like my right arm, you hear? My right arm!
Well, you want me to lay it out for you?
Yeah, go on, lay it out for me.
Rudy Hamburg was your friend.
Yeah.
And you want to lay your dirty mitts on 50,000 bucks. That's it, no more. No less.
No more, no less, huh? That makes me a rat, you know.
Yeah, that sums it up.
Okay, do you mind if we shut up about it?
Okay, we'll shut up. Now that we can discuss things, when we go back to New York, we'll talk about it in a big way.
Here. You mind putting this in the trunk?
Sylvia. Now, don't speak to me. Please believe me. Come back tomorrow. Sylvia, I'll tell you everything now. Sylvia!
Thank you.
Is that the house?
That's it. Perfectly isolated. There are too many windows on this side, so we'll have to approach it from the back and swing around to the front.
Okay. Something because of what you said earlier.
About what?
About my being a rat. I have respect for you. I want you to believe that I'm not here for the money. Give me a couple of minutes with Rudy. It's important to me that you know.
Know what?
That everything I said about him back in New York was true.
Well, what's the point?
The point is I want your respect. Now, do I have the couple of minutes or not?
You too. Give Phil your gun and no monkey business. Now bring him over.
You were expecting us, huh?
Uh-huh.
You get good information.
Mm-hmm. That's enough talk, Phil. Bring the guns over.
For whatever value it has now, Rudy. You and my sister, true or false?
The guns.
True or false?
So what?
Thanks. So what?
Can't what?
I thought about it and I can't.
What are you talking about?
It was a good try, Phil. A real good try. You're just lucky. You cut your hand on that glass on the radiator.
You must be flipping.
Come on, that bullet missed you by a mile. Now that I know, I've got to go back.
Don't kill him.
It's my job. I've got to do it. If Rudy Hamburg was a friend of mine, I would have done exactly what you did. I like you for it. But he's not my friend, and my job is to kill him. Now, don't make anything to make me shoot you, please.
Rudy never talked in his life. He won't talk now. I give you my word. Let him go.
I can't. It's my job. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. It was a good plan. You almost pulled it off. Where was Rudy going?
This was the end of the line for me. From here on in, he was on his own.
And the last shot, the one you didn't fire, that wasn't a blank, was it?
No. That was in case you noticed he wasn't dead.
I was wondering why you fired only 5 times. That really clinched it.
I was hoping you wouldn't count.
And that's why you insisted on a 440. Mm. You had all the blanks prepared, and that's why you had to go into the bushes to put them in? How did you work this out with Rudy?
I came to France a month ago. Rudy and I worked every detail out, even down to the blanks that would make a hole in his clothes.
And the tale that I had to get rid of in Paris, he was the one that warned Rudy.
Yeah. He was going to tell him where we were every minute.
Now, Phil, one last question. Were you going to shoot me with that last bullet?
I don't know.
Turn around. And don't do anything stupid, because I'm right behind you. This won't hurt.
No. I can't let you kill him. Everybody does what they've got to do.
Look, I know Rudy like I know my right arm. He'll disappear. You can trust him.
You know this is not my decision.
No.
You gotta listen.
All right, we'll go back to New York, you and me. I'll tell him I bungled it. I'll take the whole rap.
I can't. Now everything's gone crazy. I've got to make it right again.
Don't kill him. I beg you, don't kill him for the last time.